back with MrTaxes.ca with special guests and our special co-host. Make sure and tune in weekly Wednesday mornings, 9 a.m. Pacific time, 12 noon Central. Remember to subscribe and remember to smash, bash, and kick it in the you know what with that like button if you want more videos like this. Here we are. We're going live, I think. Webinar number 15 for the Side Hustle for Your Side Hustle weekly affiliate webinar with Jesse and some special guests this morning. Quentin and Bonnie, are you guys coming on or are you just going to hide out for the rest of your lives?
Bonnie's shy.
Oh yeah, that's me. Hi, Robert.
Good morning, everyone. So we're here on the West Coast at Mr. Tax's head office, the home of the Dollar Tax Club. Where's everyone else? We'll start with Bonnie.
I'm in just outside of Toronto on the East Coast.
Well, that's not quite the East Coast.
Oh, wow.
Central Coast, maybe?
Yeah,
if that's a thing.
Yeah.
And Quentin?
I'm downtown in English Bay, Vancouver here. So yeah, nice little sunny day it looks like, so. Happy to be here.
You're itching to get out on the beach, I guess?
Yeah, it's about that time. I went and played some basketball in Stanley Park last night, and the seawall was packed. So things are, coming back to life here in the city.
Do they have pickup games down there?
Yeah. There's some good games going on, and there's always people out running around, and it's a good to see people coming out after the long winter.
The long 2-year hiatus.
Well, yeah.
Jesse, where's Jesse hanging out?
Currently in beautiful snowy Alberta, and yeah, the weather is definitely not like it was in Mexico for the winter.
Is it snowing there? Do they not have sun there? You look like you're in a cave.
I am in a cave because it is snowing here. I think we've gotten about 4 inches in the last 24 hours.
And it's April 20th. How about Ontario, yeah. Bonnie? Did it hit Ontario?
You know, it's funny. A couple of nights ago, we did get it snowed for about 20 hours.
That's funny.
It was, well, because yesterday by about noon, it was completely gone.
That's an Ontario sense of humor.
There's not a stitch of snow anywhere. It was great.
Ontario sense of humor.
Yep.
So this is our weekly affiliate webinar where we bring on sales experts, gurus, online salespeople, people that work with marketing funnels, network marketing companies, training organizations. And what you're going to get every week is a little bit of info, insights from the experts. You're going to hear from Jesse and myself, Bonnie and Quentin today. They'll tell you who they're with, some things they can say, some things they can't with their organization. And then we always have a few tips, tax tips, a couple little jokes and some motivational stuff that we'll, wedge in there every now and then just to keep things light. And then more importantly, learning what you're going to learn. So what you're going to pick up from Bonnie and Quentin this week, they're both actually clients of ours and making very good revenues with what they're doing. And not everybody does make good revenues in the sales industry, but we're going to learn some tips and tricks how they are able to stay on the top of their game, week in, week out, and for quite a long duration now. And then take what you learn. Remember, grab your pen and notepad. You can always watch these on the replay, but try and grab some nuggets. You're going to get a lot of them today, especially from Bonnie with her experience in the industry, and Quentin, I guess, well traveled around the world. How many countries, Quentin?
I think it's about 30. So yeah, I lived abroad for about the last 10 years and moved back to Canada at the beginning of COVID. I was actually in Asia when the whole craziness happened. I was like warning people in like January, and then everything kind of fell apart in March. So got that.
So we can blame the whole thing on Quentin Carlin.
That's usually how it goes. Yeah, that's
no. Usually how it goes. I heard that the the World Military Games were in Wuhan in October, November of 2019, and that was the start of it. Not a lot of that in the news. We'll try not to get into too much politics here.
Yeah.
But this is our 15th webinar for the year. So we started this webinar, kicked it off in the new year with Jesse being an affiliate marketing guru, marketing funnel expert. And we've partnered up on the insurance side here in Alberta and BC, but we're also licensed across the rest of Canada. And these affiliate webinars are really just to let people know about some sales tips, tactics, techniques, anything that Bonnie and Quentin that you have today that you can, leave some golden nuggets for our listeners. It'd be much appreciated. We always tell our listeners a little bit about who we are before we get into your introduction. So our trademark's backdated to 1984. So that's right out of high school. You can do the math and figure out. You can see the birthday balloon up behind me here. That was Quentin brought me that last week. He's, we're maybe 15, 20 minutes on a SkyTrain ride apart. So he popped in the office and thanks for the balloon. It's still going. My son says, that thing's still going. Yeah. He said, you should suck the helium out of it for the webinar this week. No, we won't do that. But we had a little bit of a ride up till 2015 where we grew our practice to 42 offices. We're the third largest discounter in Canada issuing tax refunds. You know, instant refunds. We were the third largest discounter up till 2015. We sold the business, relaunched in 2018, and here we are. We're now members of the Canadian Franchise Association. So if you're a mortgage broker looking to add something onto your business, let us know. Reach out. We have a great affiliate program if you're not interested in tax as a business, but a great affiliate program. Jesse, I'll fill you in on a little bit of that a bit later. Jesse, he doesn't speak too much, but when he does, he drops the bombs.
I just like to, you know, sometimes soak in information. I don't like to be the star of the show, but for this, so I've been in the online space for about 7 years now, going on almost 7 years. Some people consider me a digital marketing mogul. I've done a lot of branding and helped a lot of different brands grow their brand and just really stand out. I've been fortunate enough to be considered number one in sales for 3 different companies through my 7-year span here so far. I've, you know, had teams of thousands of people that entrusted in me, and I was helping them grow their business and helping them just take their business to the next level, which is why we called our business Next Level Vision, because we just really love helping those visionaries take their business and turn it into something really amazing. So that's my latest and greatest business venture that I've been doing, which where we help people automate and put systems and processes together, as well as do a lot of coaching and just different programs and stuff like that. And then also lately, I've been working with Mr. Taxes and Rob and the team with helping them build their back end for their affiliate program, which we're going to dive into in a little bit, especially with the mortgage brokers and just all of the stuff we've been chatting about for the last few weeks. And also taking on some of the insurance side of things for Mr. Insurance, which is really exciting too. So that's me in a nutshell.
2 national brands. Thanks for the plug. The check's in the mail.
There you go.
So tax joke of the day. Have you heard any good jokes lately? Yeah, tax relief. So the government always puts out all of these benefits for everybody, but they take money in one hand, give it back to you in the other hand. And, you know, it's really a revelation when you get your tax refund, when you realize that that's your own money in the first place, that they just held off your employment all year. So our goal is to just minimize the amount of tax that people pay and maximize their wealth. You know, it's not something that happens overnight. It's like sales. And it's something that we work on a daily basis. So Quentin, give us a little background on yourself. And yeah, don't forget, hey, Bonnie's got to get a few words in after, right? So
no worries. I'll be fast. So yeah, like I mentioned, spent the last decade or so abroad, did a TEDx talk about traveling in different cultures and so on. Started a podcast a few years back, and that's been a great way to connect with great people like both of you guys. I got involved in the whole kind of e-commerce, internet marketing back in 2006. So I went to like a Google internet marketing seminar, saw the future of what's possible online with business, and kind of dove in since then. And been working with Bonnie and the current company we've been kind of affiliated with for the last couple of years. Won a couple of awards with them, if you see that behind there. So it's been a great ride, and I've been learning a lot from you, Robert and Jesse, just about the more financial services side of things. I'm really interested in diving deep into that as well. So that's my short little intro there.
Intro. So online space, and I know we're going to get into that a little bit. Bonnie, what's your, let's pull up Bonnie's slide here.
So I am the baby to the online space. I've only been in the online space for about 3 years now. That's how I actually met Quentin, and Quentin introduced me, of course, to you. So this is fairly new for me. Unfortunately, fairly new. I really wish I had found it back in 2006, you know, but learning as much as I possibly can, really enjoying it. And, you know, obviously learning a ton about not only how to grow my own education level in the online space to be able to help other people, but then the really important component that most people miss out on is learning how to grow your own wealth within that industry. So, you know, obviously learning all of that with you, and yeah, it's fantastic. What a ride. I'm really, really enjoying it. And yeah, looking forward to seeing what happens next.
Yeah, there's 2 sides to every online business. And I think the 2 sides are, number one is you being the experts on how to drive more revenues in for yourselves. I know both of you take incoming calls, and you're doing sales calls and coaching online. We'll learn a lot more about that in a little bit here. But once you do make that money, it's how to keep it. And I know both of you have since incorporated, you know, you started your journey with this new organization and you've hit the threshold for incorporation. And, you know, there's two reasons why somebody wants to incorporate. Number one is for liability. So if you're in a service business, a trades business, you know, you're a healthcare provider doing contracting, there's a lot of liability when you're working on people's bodies or working with, you know, humans per se, somebody's home, you know, you're working up in the roof, you don't want something crashing through the roof, you don't want to get sued and lose your home, your car, you could lose your ex, that wouldn't be so bad. But or the old adage, playing the country song backwards, right? You get your dog back, your ex back, your kids back, your job back. But the other side to incorporation is tax savings. So you've hit that threshold where you were paying big tax, both of you on one side. But we're not going to talk too much about that. We're going to talk about the sales side and really what you're doing online, what you two are doing to, you know, to close sales, you know, what's the process? We'll talk about the cycle, et cetera. And, you know, find out what each of you are doing. So Quentin, you have a little more experience on the sales side, online side. So just a little bit about the company you're working for, what and what they offer.
Yeah.
What are you offering to people that have inbound calls with you? What is the main feature?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So during COVID, everyone had a big wake up call. Like if they don't have an online presence or a brand online or a way to continue to grow their business online, they're at risk, right? That was blatantly obvious. So our businesses just went like this because people said, hey, I've got to go out and learn some new skills about digital advertising, building funnels, because the old school way of doing business and even e-commerce, it's the old school for a lot of people, right? They still have kind of just like a blank website and rely a lot on referrals. But if you're wanting to scale,
you're calling that old school, man, you're a puppy. We used to do door knocking and pick up the rotary phone.
Yeah. So I can't even imagine what life or business was without the internet. Like, it's,
and with the rotary phones, we'd skip numbers that had zeros and nines in it. It took too long for the dial to go all the way around.
All the way back around. Yeah. Actually, I do remember having one of those phones. I did have one in my house when I was young. I do remember that. But I always tell people, you know, I ask them, what's their biggest expense? And then they'll list off like their mortgage, groceries, kids. And I say, actually, your biggest expense in life is your lack of education, because the people out there that are learning are now out earning other people. And like, for example, to answer your question, very early on, we started recommending our clients getting on TikTok, right? We were one of the first providers that kind of even put a spotlight on that platform. Now, a couple years later, you see all the big gurus saying, hey, you guys might want to pay attention to this TikTok thing. I've got clients that have millions of followers on TikTok that started with us with zero. So just looking at where the trends are going in technology and business, and then positioning yourself in front of that is usually kind of what we do. So we have an online curriculum people can go through. It's kind of like a master's degree in online marketing, different tiers and so on. So that's kind of what we do.
And Bonnie, pick it up from there and just elaborate on everything that Quentin's laid out on what you guys do, just at a high level.
Of course. So we're an online education platform, or we're affiliated with an online education platform. And that's exactly what we do, is teach people skills for how to build their own business online. Because exactly as Quentin just said, so many people realize during COVID how much at risk they are when you're depending on someone else to continue to fund your lifestyle. And when that immediately was pulled away from a lot of people, they were like, oh my gosh, this isn't really working for me. So, you know, they realized how important having a presence in the online space is. So that's what we do, is we help train people how to be able to build an online business so they can fund the lifestyle that they want through a set of skills. And that's all it is learning a brand new set of skills.
So it's how to transition from scratch or take your business to another level, like Jesse's company, Next Level Marketing, but bringing things to, you know, really explode your business online. So can anybody join this program that you have to offer? How would somebody reach out to you, first of all, to both of you? Is it just email? Do you want us to share your email, or do you have a link we can share?
Yeah, I'll definitely send you. We both have links that they can come through the program. And yeah.
So just drop your links in the chat area. So those won't be available on the replay. If you're watching the replay, you won't see them. If you're watching live, you'll get them. But if you are watching it on the replay, remember, it's in the comments section below. At the top, you'll be able to grab both their links, and we'll find out what's copacetic there with the powers to be, with where you're at, what we can put on, what we can't. But we just want people to be able to reach out to you. You know, yeah. People come on and watch our replays, our webinars. And it is these, you know, our webinar is pitched as a side hustle for your side hustle. So we have our own affiliate program. And we talked about that a little bit, you know, at the beginning, at the end. But somebody coming into the online space, starting from zero. So somebody, not a spring chicken, somebody our ages, you know, let's say 40 plus, doesn't have any presence online. They don't even know what TikTok is. Where mm-hmm. does somebody start when they get into your training program? Yeah.
So that was me, because I actually was a student of the program that Quentin and I are affiliated with right now. I came in as a student, as a 40 plus student, because I wanted to learn how to build my own business online and remove myself from working for someone else. So they come through, you know, it's a 15-day challenge where they're learning a set of skills, and then they're given a couple of different alternatives to enhance those skills. But we have many members come in from scratch, you know, anywhere from 18 to 82, tons of members. It doesn't matter if they have any experience or not. We have a lot of members that are very experienced, like Jesse, in the online space, who are looking to up their skill set and increase or build additional streams of revenue. So it's accessible and really easy to, it's a very simple business model.
Everybody's looking for the silver bullet. Even experts like Jesse and what we're doing, we put a lot of money into our marketing funnels and our online presence. We have two full-time marketing people that work for us. They have two full-time salaries. You know, some people spend a couple $100 a month. You know, for us, that's about $7,000 to $8,000 a month for two full-timers. Mm-hmm. And it's paying dividends for us, but we'd always like to refine things and get more value for what we're doing. So somebody that does have an in-house marketing person like we do, or somebody with a mid-sized company that has somebody either part-time or full-time, is this a program that somebody like that could take on, or organization could take that on for their in-house marketing team?
Yeah, I think the reason why a lot of our members do get the results that they get and are so successful is because we have like a step-by-step blueprint. Like as Bonnie said, you know, we've got members here even in their 70s and 80s that have been featured on our, we kind of have something like similar what you do. We have a wake-up show that we interview our members every single day, Monday to Friday. And that's very rare in the online info space that actually companies interview their own customers and clients, because a lot of these big gurus out there, they'll be having their podcasts and interviewing other gurus, but not a lot of them want to actually spotlight their own students and members, because sometimes with a lot of these programs out there, and I want to warn people that there's a lot of options of different kind of companies and things. You want to do your due diligence to make sure that there's actually a good community, the support is there, and people are actually getting results, right? There's a big difference from going to like Harvard or like, you know, the community college next door, you know, with the quality of just education. And that's what we are essentially, as an education company. So we have a blueprint that people go through. We've got group coaching, masterminds, a whole lot of different things to help people wherever they're at.
Yeah, one of the people on our team is new, but the person that they replaced left, they moved on somewhere else, but they spent $40,000 on a marketing degree. Yeah. And they came here and I was showing them things to do. You know, they didn't know how to put together a basic marketing strategy or plan, which is things that we've developed over the years. But here's somebody who went through and paid $40,000 at one of the local career colleges that didn't get, I don't believe they got value for their money. Some of them do it for the you know, the immigration purpose, you know, is, you know, coming through the education channel to get immigration. But still, I believe that the education industry is a little bit predatory, which is what I like about your program.
Yeah, I think that, I mean, I hear that all the time. People come here with an MBA. And I say, okay, so you've already got an LLC set up, like for our American clients. And like, what is that? I'm like, you just spent, you know, over $100,000 for like an advanced master's degree. And they don't even know the benefits of having a home business to write off their expenses. So it's pretty crazy. I'm like, well, what do you guys learn during that? Because I think a lot of these colleges and universities, they're outdated. They don't talk about Facebook ads. They don't talk about funnels. They're still talking about like theories and branding and like just... Not that branding's not important, but it's just like, what's getting results in today's marketplace? What's working now? And they have no idea, and they don't expose their students to what's actually getting results nowadays.
Little motivational piece I got out of a movie. This is an old movie, dating myself, is Cocktails with Tom Cruise.
I remember that movie.
And there was a scene where he was in the classroom and he had it out with the teacher. And I think he walked out of the class telling the teacher, you know, if you're such an expert, why are you sitting there teaching? Right. Well, but some people do teach because they love giving back. We started a tax course and we give the first modules in the course away for free as members in our Dollar Tax Club. So for a buck, you get the modules free. It's a little bit empowering teaching. Do you get the same feeling when you're on with your, I know you're taking sales calls, but you're also doing coaching calls. Bonnie's shaking her head. So what kind of empowerment do you feel when you're giving back that knowledge?
The greatest thing I do every single day, I get to take a trip around the world and help other people see the greatness in themselves. That is the most rewarding thing. I've been in the sales business for 25 years. That's what I did for a living before I came into the online space. And the biggest thing that I learned coming into the online space, everything I learned in my sales career, I had to leave at the door. It's not welcome here. It doesn't work in the online space. It wasn't about selling. It's about helping people see through education that they can absolutely make entirely different decisions and change the trajectory of their life by learning a new set of skills. And exactly what Quentin just said, hit the nail on the head. Unfortunately, in school, you're learning things that don't necessarily apply at all to the online digital space anymore. And let's face it, in the digital world, marketing strategies change at all the time, very regularly. You need to be kept updated on that. One of the greatest things about what we do is we're constantly and continuously educating ourselves on what's been changing and what's been happening so that we can help our members see that as well, so that they can be as successful as possible. So yeah, the selling game, It's not a part really of the online space anymore, in my opinion.
Well, the products have to sell themselves. Quentin.
Yeah, I was going to say my the first couple of years of my university career was actually in education. I was actually going to become a teacher. And then I transferred that into counseling and kind of pre-law conflict resolution and mediation communications. And I find that was probably one of the best things to learn in university, like solving problems, because basically all you do as an entrepreneur is help people solve their problems. And you've got to become a good listener. You know, I think the best salespeople, people think that, oh, you have to have the gift of the gab. I think that couldn't be further from the truth. The best salespeople are the people that can listen and find out if there's even a sale to be made in the first place, to see if that person has a problem that you can give a solution for, right? Kind of like what Bonnie said, a lot of people out there that are constantly pitching or the ABCs always be closing, they're usually not the best people as far as, you know, bringing on clients, because there's that sales resistance, right? People are smart. They know when people are just trying to sell them something, right? With the way that the world is these days, you can go and do a Google review on anything and anyone, right? So I think it's more about connecting and collaborating than closing deals.
Yeah, you got to build that foundation. Jesse, what have you found?
You guys are hitting a lot of nails on the head. I'm just like soaking it in and listening, and just everything you're saying is just like, yep, checking that box. I think the same way. I've completely eliminated the word sales out of my vocabulary and switched it with enrollment, because at the end of the day, we enroll people in the online space. We don't sell people. Sales is an old term to me. Like you think of sales, you think of car sales, greasy car sales. And I just completely eliminated that, swapped it out for enroll, and it just feels so much better. And even in all of our sales copy, marketing, everything that we put together, it's enroll now instead of buy now, right? And it's made a huge difference in not only just getting more enrollments, but also just having that community feel where, you know, nobody feels like they were forced into being there, which is amazing. Everyone wants to be there.
You watched the Brian Tracy video I sent you the other day, Quentin, and at the end, you know, partway through there, he said he didn't feel like he was sold an insurance policy.
Yeah.
You know, he felt empowered to have it. He felt like he got $1 million insurance policy, and he felt like $1 million person. You know, his family was protected, et cetera. So it's, and he said in that video, you know, he didn't have buyer's remorse, not for one moment. So that's the type of experiences you want. But the beautiful thing about what you're doing with the clients, you work with them on the front end, on the enrollment side. See, I'm getting up to speed on the terminology. But then you also get to work with them on the coaching side, you know, from going through the program. So talk to us a little bit about what that looks like, that process. You know, once somebody's enrolled, once they give their endorsement, you know, they get signed up for the program. What are the next steps? What are some of the first steps or some of the first calls that you go through with them?
Yeah. Well, we're really big on over delivering, right? Like we want people to be like, wow, we get all of this. So I think support is really important for people, because when someone is new to all of this, like a lot of our members are, because people right now, we've got record unemployment, people pivoting careers. So this is brand new for them. And I always tell them, I mean, unfortunately, the online space has this idea that everything, you know, if you just buy this, you're going to make money tomorrow. And that can be further from the truth, right? I tell people, look, treat this as like a 6 month to 12 month master's degree, because that's really what it is. Mm-hmm. And yes, you can earn while you learn, but just go through the process and give yourself time, because time's passing anyway, right? Time takes time, and you're going to spend your time watching Netflix or learning new skills that can actually pay off now and create these, I call it digital real estate. You know, you're building digital assets, and we have a whole process of onboarding people through a variety of live calls every single week that they can jump on to ask our advisors any questions, get support, collaborate with other members through our mastermind groups that we do. We're doing another one in Florida next month in a couple of weeks coming up. So yeah, there's a lot of support. And I really think that that's why 95% of regular businesses fail, when people are solo without a system and support, where 95% of franchises succeed, because there is that system to follow, the support, and like the community. And that's what we try and do, is kind of create an online franchise model, and it seems to be working well.
I like the analogy about time is time. Two things came to mind when you said that. Number one was the Jelly Bean Life video on YouTube, where they dump 85,000 jelly beans, and that's for one for every day of your life. And then they start slicing them off. You know, how many hours do you commute to work? How many hours do you spend watching TV? How many hours scrolling on your phone, etc.? And then it shows how much time you actually have left. And the other thing that came to mind was Simon Sinek's video on, and we'll make sure and get these in the comment section on when this goes up on YouTube. But Simon Sinek talked about the infinite versus the finite game or business. You know, some people are in it to win it. And, you know, what constitutes winning? You know, you can win the gold medal this year, and next year you're, you know, 10,000th in the world. I was training for the 96 Olympics with Robert Esme. And Robert Esme, if you don't know, he's the one who handed off the baton to Donovan Bailey for the 4x100 gold medal. So here's one of the fastest guys in the world. And he was training here in just outside Vancouver at one of the local gyms. We were both preparing for the 96 Olympics, and he was recovering from a hamstring injury, did not qualify. Here he was 4 years later, one of the top sprinters in the world. 4 years later, he's working at a shoe store in Surrey. And, wow. You know, that's how fast it can end. So you got to make the most of your time. I told him about the story where we were training. I used to sneak into the gym every morning about 20 minutes early, and I'd push the treadmill just ahead of the treadmill that he was on. I'd get on and warm up, and he would come in, and it was about 6 inches ahead of him. So I was always looking back when we were chatting on the treadmill. We'd warm up for about 15, 20 minutes. And here I was, just psychologically, I was, you know, ahead of the fastest guy in the world. And I ran into him years later. He works at a custom orthotic foot store in Surrey, and we'll give them a plug. It's Kintech in Surrey, BC. But he told him about that story years later, and he chased me around the store. He said, "You cost me a gold medal, man." But psychology has a lot to do with it. What kind of mindset do you put people in on these calls? You know, do you prepare them for the calls? Is there a set chronological order for the calls when they go through the program?
There is. And that's exactly what I was just going to touch on. That's key. 95% of what we do as successful entrepreneurs is mindset driven. Whether you tell yourself you can or you cannot do something, you're right every time. So most people coming into the space, like myself, when I was brand new, I had to rewire my mindset to remove the employee mentality and rewire everything to think like an entrepreneur. And exactly what Quentin said, it's all problem solving. All we're doing all day is helping people understand, you know, how to fix their current situation. And most people, like Quentin said, come in saying, okay, well, I want to make money tomorrow. The money doesn't matter. It's the why behind you want to do that. If I gave you $1 million right now, what are you going to do with it? You want to get down to why they want to do this, because your why is always stronger than your quit. And it's going to promote you to keep going, keep educating yourself, keep reading books about how to grow your wealth, all of the other things that come into the pocket of becoming an entrepreneur. So we guide them through that with a series of calls to help them understand that if this is something they want to do, you need to surround yourself with the best. You need to have a supportive community. You need to have, you know, the all the education behind you to make this a success for you. And the more people feel empowered to do that through conversations that are uncomfortable. Let's face it. As an employee, people stay in the same spot forever because it's comfortable. Most of them don't enjoy it, but they do it because that's what's familiar. So the conversations that we have, a lot of them are very uncomfortable. But when you come out on the other end, that's when your whole life changes.
Yeah, I saw something on Instagram yesterday, and you asked how people can connect. I'm active on Instagram. I'm the only coaching Carlin in the world, so I'm easy to find.
Yeah.
But this Instagram post said, you know, a lot of people complain that people are born with like a better set of circumstances and just a silver spoon or whatever. But it said if everyone just started at zero now, the people that are at the top now will be at the top again, because it's not what they were given. It's about what they created. And like you said, Robert, that mindset about competitiveness. And I was out for dinner last night with a friend. She's got a really successful business. And I was just kind of like talking with her about people get to the 1%, right? The 1% in athletics. She talked about sports earlier. Like, I have a background in basketball. Like, I played college and pro briefly in Asia. But the people that are the top producers in business or the top players in a team, they just put in the work, right? They're the ones that are in the gym shooting hoops when practice is done. They're the ones that it's Friday night and they're not at the club. They're reading books or going to seminars. That's what the difference. Just how hard are you going to outwork the
other people? And you talked about that, but I see the Jordan jersey in the background. I heard a story about Jordan, about how many winning shots he had, how many final or game-winning baskets he had, how many NBA winning championships. He won the NCAA with the final buzzer shot. But what people don't know is how many shots he missed.
I know.
And the, you know, the stat was staggering. He was like in the top 10%. Yeah, in the top 10% of players that have missed shots.
Yeah.
But it's taking that risk, taking, you know, no pun intended, the shot, you know, take a shot at it, go for it.
And that's the key. Most people miss when they're coming into the space or trying to grow. When it gets tough, it's what you do behind the scenes that people can't see that are going to propel you forward. If you keep doing it, you have to keep doing it over and over. You have to keep learning. You have to keep growing. You know, Quentin and I are very competitive together because that's fun for us. He was talking about his two awards there. He's still waiting for the third, which is the big one, which I already have. And I'm the first woman in the company.
Well, that's what I told them when they started giving it.
You've been here 2 years longer than me, so don't
worry. I've been here less than 6 months longer than him, so he's fibbing.
Bonnie, when they start giving out gold medals for second and third place, then Quentin might have a chance. There you go.
That's right. But that's what helps Quentin and I grow. We have a very healthy competition because we both want to succeed and we both want each other to succeed. So, you know, if I'm having an off time, you know, Quentin will be the first one to let me know, but he'll also be the first one to help me out if I say, look, I need some assistance. That's great with, and again, all coming back to becoming an entrepreneur, you need that support. You need that community. You need to be able to go to certain people that, you know, that really want you to excel and want you to grow, because that, of course, comes back to mindset. People who are vulnerable and people who are asking for help and educating themselves on a Friday night as opposed to watching Netflix. Those are the people that are going to succeed. And even when it gets tough, you will keep going. Yeah. And Jesse, yeah, you know that, obviously. You're very successful.
Yeah, I would 100% agree with that. I always tell people in my community, you know, we'll do competitions every now and then, friendly competitions, see who can get the most enrollments in a week or whatever the case is. And I always tell people, I'm going to be on the sidelines rooting for you, but I'm also going to be leading the pack for you, and I'm not going to make it easy for you to pass me.
So there's Quentin and I, we were invited to the Vancouver Canuck game the other night. So there's a picture of Quentin with Darcy Rota, longtime Vancouver player, with Darcy Rota's card. And what other images do we have here just to share with everyone? There's in the middle, a client of ours, Garth Rizzuto, with the beard. He is an original Canuck, played on the first team. And in the background, you can see the original photo, team photo, for the Vancouver Canucks. And a little bit of history on that photo that Quentin might have learned, that photo was not taken in Vancouver. It was actually taken in Minnesota, because the original owner of the Canucks also owned the Ice Capade, and they were in Minnesota that week, and they wanted the Canucks to take a photo opportunity and go out and do the, you know, the social media thing with the team from the Ice Capades. That's a little bit of history that's up in the alumni booth at the game. So those are some of the things that we do, you know, as a team. Jesse is in Alberta and closer to Edmonton, so he gets to enjoy, you know, the Edmonton Oilers victories. Vancouver's never won a cup, though, so we better stop talking about this stuff. We don't want to.
Well, thanks again for the invite there, Robert. That was awesome. And talking about Edmonton, you know, I grew up in Edmonton, and I remember back in the dynasty days with the Oilers. And talking about, like, the athlete's mindset, you know, Gretzky, he's got that famous quote that you miss 100% of the shots that you never take. And unfortunately, a lot of people never get off the bench to get into the game because of their own limiting beliefs, right? People say, oh, well, one day I want to do this, or that sounds good, but I couldn't do it. I think that everyone has the opportunity, and people that do excel in business are just the people that simply get started with it, right? You're not going to hit a home run the first time in business. Usually most people fail. What's the stat? Like something like 80% of all millionaires went bankrupt before they made it, right? Like, so, you know, you got to just kind of keep picking yourself back up and learning and growing and developing.
Yeah. Once you set your mind on it, it's like putting your mind, you know, if I told you to picture the Olympic rings, you know, the five rings interconnected. And I tell you now, don't picture those Olympic rings. It's kind of hard to get that thought process out of your head. And I think it was, you know, that cocktail movie with Tom Cruise. When I heard that scene, you know, the whole movie was about entrepreneurship. But when I heard that scene about the teacher, I was actually taking some accounting courses in college. I didn't finish high school, went back to try and learn a little bit about accounting. Forewent that after I saw that movie and went down to Florida. And, you know, a year and a half later, I was deported from the U.S. because I was working without a green card. So there are rules, you know, to working in foreign countries. But, you know, I gave it a shot. You know, I went out and took that shot at it, left high school, thought I'd be a millionaire in a year. And it does take time. We all think we're going to do it. And that was before the internet. I mean, there is another birthday being celebrated. So we're long before the internet.
Yeah. Well, I think that the other thing too, is that talking about what we do, the internet levels the playing field, right? Because before in the past, to start a business, you would need hundreds of thousands of dollars to go out and invest in like office space, employees, get all the equipment. But now, for literally a couple hundred bucks, you can be in business like today or tomorrow, right? It's really leveled the playing field for people, and it's really been a game changer. And we see people come in here that are like, you know, 17 years old. We had one guy that was still in high school, and he was making more than both of his parents combined, you know, in high school. So it's pretty crazy to see what people can really create. And it's awesome.
It's amazing. And something that you just said, Robert, and it's key, and we've touched on it a couple times. Fear is the motivating factor for any decision you're going to make in life anyway. Fear is going to motivate you to stay the same, or fear is going to motivate you to change. 6 months is going to pass. You're going to have 6 months worth of excuses or 6 months worth of education and growth. As soon as you decide to let fear move you into a different direction and say, you know, I'm just going to get started on TikTok, or I'm just going to do this, or I'm just going to build this, you will continue to grow. Or you're going to let fear say, oh, I can't really do that. I'll wait one day. One day is never going to come.
Yeah, we're 15 webinars this year. A year and a half ago, actually, when COVID started, we had a marketing person on board with us. And when COVID hit, she disappeared. She was Chinese, went back to China right away, you know, to be with her family, which, you know, we supported her in doing. But we had just started advertising for our first webinar. So here, our first webinar is coming up in less than 3 days. She disappears, and we get nobody to run Webinar Jam. So we fumbled through it. And about the third webinar in, I hit this little button. It was, you know, it looked like a telephone there. I thought it was to put the, you know, mute the speaker, and I shut off the entire webinar. I just ended the webinar, just a click of a button. So, you know, take that first step, you know, take a shot at it. Talk to somebody who's done it. I'm sure you have a lot of endorsements, referrals, testimonials. Any way that listeners can reach out to find out more about the program that you guys are involved in? If somebody's interested in chatting with you guys, how do they reach out to you?
I think for me, you can send me a DM on Instagram. That's the simplest, or we'll provide you with the links.
And so what's your Instagram?
It's just my name, Quentin Carlin. I'm the only one with my name on the internet, so it's easy for people to find me. So just Quentin Carlin there. We'll have the link below as well for the curriculum. Bonnie, how can people connect with you?
Not Quentin Carlin.
No. I'll drop my link right here, actually. They can come in, or, you know,
drop the link in the chat, then we'll make sure and get it in the comments for the replay.
I'll drop it in the chat. They can also reach out to me on Instagram.
What is your Instagram?
The real Bonnie King? I am not the only Bonnie King in the world, believe me. So my Instagram is Bonnie K Fitness. BONNIEK Fitness. And I just dropped my link in the chat. So
there's another one, Bonnie K Fitness on Instagram. Mm-hmm. So talking about TikTok, are either one of you on TikTok?
Not really. I'm not. Yeah. I don't know if I'm old school, but I like Instagram more my wheelhouse. Yeah.
I'm a big Instagram fan too. Although that said, I am going to go on TikTok. I'm not afraid to go on TikTok. I just haven't done it as of yet. I use it more for research, but I like Instagram. Like Quentin, Instagram's my favorite platform. I do enjoy it, but got to get with the times. Got to get on TikTok.
So yeah, when are you two going to make a bid for Instagram? Elon Musk has made a bid for
Twitter.
He already owns almost 10% of it. He probably owns more than that. He probably has shares on the side through some holdings.
Yeah, it's interesting. It's interesting, you know, like we've just seen these platforms really dictate society, right? Like Facebook. And the thing too now with like cancel culture is people can lose their entire livelihoods just like this. Like, look at how many people are just deplatformed for whatever reason. You know, these tech companies are
the president of the United States. Yeah. E-platform. There you go.
Like, it's crazy how, like, it's a weird, weird world we're living in right now. Yeah, it definitely is.
But it's not like Elon Musk couldn't go out and start another platform. I was just looking at a fella here. What was his name? The Rubin Report. David Rubin. Yeah. Was on an interview yesterday. Listened to that a little bit. He started a platform on his own, and there's a whole bunch of them. Signal and
there's a lot of
Parler.
There's a lot of people that are kind of putting together, and I think like blockchain and the whole metaverse is going to be the next big play with how people interact. So the technology is always evolving, and it's, you know, important to have the education on how to stay on top of it.
Yeah, I would agree 100% with that, because even from a marketing standpoint, the opportunities that are going to come through the metaverse and the advertising potential and just everything that's coming with that, like just kind of how you guys were talking earlier about how you were warning people to get onto TikTok. My warning would be, if you don't know about the metaverse, you don't know about Web3, and you're in branding, marketing, or you're growing a business or growing a presence, definitely look into that.
Well, I don't know if you guys are familiar with EXP, but it's the biggest brokerage, and they've got their own metaverse, right? Like, they've got their whole digital community where agents are walking around with their, with what's that called? Like
avatar.
Avatar. Yeah, it says that. Yeah. Yeah. So we're right there.
So glad I could help there, Quentin. So glad I could help.
Thanks, buddy.
No worries.
Yeah.
EXP is growing exponentially. They are, you know, a multi-level marketing real estate firm. I think they're close to 100,000 brokers now around the world. So there is power in network marketing. I mean, Avon proved it. What are the other ones? Avon, Herbalife, Monavie, Amway. I mean, they've grown into billion-dollar companies. But the unfortunate thing there is it's only, you know, 5% at the top. Those who get in early that take advantage, you know, that really drive their revenues, because it is a network marketing or affiliate marketing model. What is it that your training program really teaches people to do? So it's not an affiliate marketing program. We've nailed that. It's just showing people how to go from offline to online and start their own business.
Yeah, it's really like an educational master's degree in online marketing, right? So people can choose what curriculums, if they're wanting to do Facebook ads, if they're wanting to learn how to build funnels and landing pages, if they're wanting to learn how to write copy, right? If they want to learn how to give better video presentations, right? Like video sales letters, things like that. And also for people that do have an established business, we show them how to go into these databases and digital libraries to find products. Like, let's say that you're a fitness trainer, right? You can go out and sell your time for money to go and train clients. But if you want to have some monetization on the back end that's automated, you can offer some other courses or programs that people can click on your affiliate link, and their clients that upgrade to buy whatever they need, that fitness trainer can monetize on that client. So affiliate marketing is basically just finding a niche that you want to go into, finding really good offers, and then just offering them to existing or potential clients.
Adding another revenue stream to what you're already doing.
Yeah.
Which is what we're doing here, Jess. You know, Jesse and I have added insurance. We have a national brokerage now, so we're offering insurance at, you know, across Canada. We've added investment brokerage. We have a national affiliate program with mortgage brokers, so we don't have a mortgage license. So that's one way that we communicate with mortgage brokers. So it's very easy to double, triple, quadruple your revenue just by adding that additional revenue stream.
The one-stop shop for all financial advice and resources.
I really have to acknowledge you, Roberts. Over the last 2 years, I mean, I've learned so much about just financial education that I thought I knew pretty well. But I mean, there's different levels to the game, and you are the Mr. Miyagi of this industry. So I just want to say it's an honor and a privilege to get to know you and learn from you. And just I mean, I can't give any higher recommendation for people to look into all the services that you offer. So
yeah, very, very easy to get involved with us. DollarTaxClub.ca if you're a mortgage broker /affiliates. But one of the, you know, a very easy way to get involved is just pay the dollar, come in, enjoy the replays, enjoy the all of the handouts that we have, discounts on tax services, and all of our complimentary financial services are free. You know, tax is really the only service that we can charge for, and we're looking at waiving those fees at some point, you know, when we can get to the next level, so to speak. So there it is on the screen. Easy way to get involved with us.
I want to second what Quentin said, actually, because Quentin introduced me to you a year ago, and the amount of information that I have learned in the last year about how to keep my money as opposed to giving it away, which I've done for many, many years, in all different aspects is unbelievable. And there's, you have so many resources that I can go and research and learn and educate myself, along with, you know, being able to talk to you and other people in the organization, you know, as quickly as, can I ask a question? Can I have some help? So, I mean, I really, really appreciate everything that you do. Thank you so much for, you know, helping the rest of us learn how to keep our money.
Yeah. And thanks for coming on and sharing your tips and tricks with the listeners. You know, most of the ones that come on board are looking for a side hustle or how to complement their side hustle. But one of the big programs that we launched is an affiliate program for mortgage brokers. So mortgage brokers are able to receive referral commissions from us. They get social media and website exposure because we create all the content for them that they can just post. They don't have to worry about design software, et cetera, and discounted services for brokers and their clients. That's our latest affiliate program. If you want to learn more, just reach out. And here's a little tax tip. So tune in every week. We got a couple of these. So why not move your closing date on the sale of a rental property to January 1st? Why would you do that? Because you're going to defer your tax for 16 months. Any tax owing on capital gains on a rental property. And Canada Revenue is looking, our federal government is looking at waiving the capital gains exemption on primary residences. So those are the type of things that we stay on top of. And here's a guy that I watch a lot of, Simon Sinek. So the challenge of the unknown future is so much more exciting than the stories of the accomplished past. And we heard that the other night at the hockey game. You know, there was one fella there, big guy. He's probably not as big as Quentin, but 6'4". You know the guy I'm talking about. Heavy set guy. He's driving a truck now for a living. Spent 6 years in the NHL, and now he's relegated to driving a truck. And they're telling stories about, you know, years gone by in the NHL. And then Garth comes in and starts talking to him about, you know, he had a fall off his truck almost, you know, he was worried about that because he couldn't survive without a second job now. So, you know, pro sports isn't all it's made out to be. And that's the beautiful thing about creating an online business. You know, you get to create the future. You know, it's here to stay. TikTok ain't going nowhere.
There'll be a new thing in a couple of years as well. So, yeah, it's an all ongoing evolution. And you're right, Robert. Like, you know, like I love sports and I follow a lot of athletes and so on. And I think that the average football player, I'm not really a big football guy, but I think that they've got the shortest careers. And the majority of them,
I think it's under 3 years, the average NFL career.
Yeah. And like you said, they make millions of dollars. And then I think it's like 5 years out of the NFL, like 90% of them are broke. right? Like there's all these stories of guys working at Starbucks and all this stuff. Like it's crazy how people can just kind of fall off that cliff.
I have a friend in Ottawa. He's still there, runs a gym now. He was the highest ever drafted offensive lineman out of the CIAU Canadian football. He got drafted into the NFL, went down. He had I think it was a $500,000 signing bonus. I believe it was Philadelphia Eagles. He went down to the training camp, blew out his knee in training camp, never played a game. You know, he used that money to start a business and built it up, you know, over the years. But, you know, those, you know, it's such a fine line between success and failure. Why not take the chance on success?
Well, and the key to that too is when you read about like professional athletes, like you're talking about, or lottery winners, making more money, if you're not financially literate, you're just going to spend more money or lose more money. You have to learn how to make your money work for you so you can keep that money. That's the key. You know, you hand someone, you know, $2 million and they don't know what to do with $2 million. They'll spend $2 million like that.
Well, you made the offer earlier and we can replay this. It's on camera. You offered $1 million. And I was going to say, when you're writing that checkout, Stone is spelled S-T-O-N-E. When you're ready to write that check. The other joke we have with that is you were talking about traveling and visitors, you know, your clients from all over the world, which is cool to see because we're, you know, our clients are in Canada because we're a Canadian tax and financial service company, but it must be pretty cool talking to people around the world. And people ask, you know, can I write off my trip to this exotic place? Can I write off my trip to that exotic place? I say, yeah, as long as you bring your accountant, it's 100% tax deductible.
See you in Mexico.
Yeah, the bags are packed. Jesse spent, I think, almost 6 months down there this winter. And Quentin, you were down there for quite a while. A lot of people, you know, a lot of people are looking at rules. What are the rules about leaving Canada for certain periods of time? Those are things we can help with too.
Yeah.
We should collaborate on a book.
Yeah. The exodus from Canada. Well, yeah. I think that a lot of people are also looking at now that everyone's working remote. And we talked about athletes, right? But a lot of people that are not athletes, but had a career for 20 years. And then all of a sudden they're laid off because the company's downsizing. I mean, what next? So a lot of people are seeing that they've got to learn new skills to be competitive in the marketplace, right? And they're also seeing that, hey, I don't have to live in Canada. I could go live in Bali for 6 months out of the year, reduce my expenses, and run an online business and grow it that way. So that's a pretty cool way to have an adventurous lifestyle as well.
So what's next for both of you? You've incorporated, you're both at the top of the game. You know, within your organization, any ventures you guys are looking at on the outside? I know you have a podcast you run, Quentin, Bonnie, anything on the horizon for you? What's the next step?
Yeah, for me, I'm going to start a couple of different affiliate streams that I'll become a part of to, you know, promote products that I endorse, that I agree with, that I encourage other people to get involved in. So that'll be my next step. And then, we'll see what the future holds.
Well, speaking of affiliate programs, dollartaxclub.ca, reach out to Bonnie. She has an affiliate link. So does Quentin.
My goal is I want to be the next Robert Stone. So looking at getting my, you know, financial education.
Often imitated, but never duplicated.
That's right. And
you got to work at knocking Bonnie off her perch there first. So the lead, you know, Quentin, the lead donkey is the only one that ever gets a change of view.
I like the view of looking at English Bay on here. I wouldn't change it for anything right now.
That's now I know why you're not number one. I know exactly why. We had an office there overlooking the waterfront in Vancouver for 15 years, and after the first 2 months, I moved my office to an inside office, so I didn't have a window. I got nothing done.
Yeah. Wow. I can relate. Yeah.
Thank you so much for having us on, Robert. It was such a pleasure to be here.
That's awesome. Any, you know, we didn't get too many questions. A lot of salespeople think they know it all, but, you know, you're never too smart to learn something new. I think Einstein said that, you know, it's a never ending game. What's up next, Jesse? Next week we have Phylogix coming on again. Haley from Phylogix is going to be talking a little bit about the software, how to get the most out of the Phylogix software, which is a national platform for mortgage brokers. That'll be webinar number 16. What do you got coming up next week, Jess? Any insights for those on our affiliate program? Any sneak previews next week?
So we've been working really hard on the back end system, just getting it all prepped for these mortgage brokers that are flooding in. We have 40 spots available. Well, not anymore. A lot of those.
They're going fast.
Yeah, they're going fast. We have 40 total. So if you're watching this and you're curious about it, definitely jump on board, get set up with that. And we're going to start putting together some different trainings and resources for everyone moving forward as well. That's exciting.
That was a mortgage broker calling you right there, Robert. He's ready to go.
Yeah, it actually is. Yeah. You know, we work with the National Mortgage Channel there with Filogix. They have 17,000 brokers. Our links on their platform, so they reach out all the time. Usually, when they're in a bind, you know, the 11th hour, getting documents for their clients. Okay, so I think that's a wrap for another week. Lots of insights. Anybody wanting to reach out, remember in the comment section on the replay, it'll be down below on YouTube. And if you can't find it and you're listening to this, reach out to us at Mr. Taxes. We'll put you in touch with Bonnie and or Quentin and get you know in touch with them so you can learn more about their program, what they're offering, how they're bringing, you know, people from offline, online, and transforming their businesses. We'll end it off with our usual video, and we'll see everybody in another week.